Welcome to the greenhouse. I'm Alex. This is a how-to video where I'm going to show you how to make the little flux chambers that we use for our photosynthesis and respiration experiments. Come on in. When we want to quantify the rate of change of a gas like carbon dioxide, we need to work with a fixed volume of gas. This is because our instrument measures the concentration of carbon dioxide, in most cases, in units of parts per million, that is, the number of CO2 molecules in 1 million molecules of air. So if we have twice as much air, we'll have twice as much carbon dioxide. That's why we need to build a sample chamber with a fixed and known volume. By far, the easiest volume to work with is 1 liter. One of anything will make our calculations much easier, and it gives us one less place to make a mathematical error. Here are all the materials that we're going to need. Plastic juice bottles make great flux chambers. Clear plastic is good for photosynthesis, and it's flexible enough that we can cut it up to any shape or size we want. I'm going to start with a 52-ounce juice bottle. That's 1.6 liters. And I'm going to peel off the labels so that the sunlight will pass through. And then to make this a 1 liter container, I'm going to need 1 liter of water. Now you can measure a liter with a beaker if you've got one, or a measuring cup, or even a 1 liter soda bottle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour the water in. I'm going to put the cap on, and I'm going to turn it upside down. So now, once the water settles down, I can draw a line all the way around the bottle at the 1 liter mark. Get the water out, and we're going to cut the bottle. So we're going to very carefully cut this on the mark. All right, and once you've cut it off, you can trim it up and make it even. And it's good to make it even. You don't want any little pokey things on this. Okay. Now, for photosynthesis, I'm going to need the bottom half as well. So I'm going to trim this down a little bit because we just need to be able to close up the bottom. There we go. Okay, so now these two pieces will fit together so that we can close this around our plant. All right, and I'm going to need to make a notch in the corner of both halves so that we can put a stem or some leaves in here. Now, the top of the bottle should, you need to check this ahead and make sure that the opening on the top of the bottle is going to fit your CO2 probe. And fitting it in nice and loose is fine because we're looking at the gas fluxing through the chamber. For a respiration experiment, we don't want the light to shine through the bottle. So we're going to take some duct tape and cover the bottle up. And also, this is what it will look like covered in duct tape. Notice that I've actually cut this one a little bit below my line, and that's so I can push this into the soil nice and firmly and have the soil level be at that 1 liter mark. The other thing I need to know for respiration flux is I need to know the cross-sectional area of the chamber. Okay, so This is about 10 centimeters by 11 centimeters. And there we are. We're ready to go out and to measure two of the most important parts of the carbon cycle.